Hey, welcome back to the KAASM channel. So, Sean, what are we doing today?
Well, today we are going to look at an SQL query panel, the table. So we had training this week, and they set up a few archives, like login data, and they wanted to be able to check their data and just do some queries. And so I figured let's do this week's video on that.
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah, you want to check it out? All right, so here's the Getty. And to get to the query panel, actually, let me back up. I usually, with all these demos, use the pre-built project, the WinCC OA Getting Started project, because it's already got everything built. So I just go use
it.
Yeah, so I just want to show the clicks on how to get to that. So inside of the Getty of the Getting Started project, I go to System Management, then we go to Reports, and then we go to the SQL Query tool, all right? Once we get to this panel, it gives us the choice to pick a value, you know, type or alerts. I'm just gonna look at some of the process values inside of OA that already have like the configured archives running and so on.
Okay.
And then from there, we're gonna select online, let me get to it, online value, which is the value coming out of WinCC OA. You'll see original value in there. What that is that's the value from the PLC before there's any value ranges added to it. And then online or offline is like correction values. So we are gonna pick online, which is the WinCC OA data. We're gonna add it to that select, hit the check mark. Then we're gonna say from where. So in this from statement, we're gonna select the data point. And so this data point, because this is the getting started system, I'm just going to go in here and grab the getting started level because I know there's data in there. Okay. Going to hit OK. Going to click this button and move it to the from statement. Hit the check mark. And then remote, this is for if we've got a distributed system and I want to run a query and grab data from a distributed remote WinCC OA station. Where, I'm not going to do a where statement because there's some comparison values in here, but you can do that. Time range, I'm just gonna leave that blank. We're just gonna pull all data for however long I've had this running, all right? Sort group, not going to touch this either, but now I get to my data table here. So I'm going to say create query, and this essentially does the SQL query select statement that I want. And then I'm going to say start query. And there's all of my data
cool,
in the table.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, pretty sweet, right? And so one of the things in training that happened this week was like, well, where's the timestamp, right? Well, that's when we go back to the select statement and I can go, okay, let's get the time, bam. And let's get a user or the manager it came from or whatever. But I'm just gonna do the timestamp there, create query, see, notice how it changed that, and then I can start query again and I get another column.
Oh, great.
Okay. So you can see how this could be useful. It's a quick tool to just verify data, to look at some timestamps and variables. But that's this week's tutorial.
Cool, pretty great. Can you then export or save this data?
So last week we did the variable trend tool, and that's where we would export data easily with like a CSV file. In this week's video, we're just simply looking at it. So the short answer is no, but we can save this query statement and run it here again. But what we can do is take this SQL or this query select statement right here, and we can actually use this inside of the OA application where maybe we click a button or create an ODBC connection to another database, then we can pull the data out of OA and get it there as well.
Great.
So it allows us to make data accessible.
Got it.
Okay. Thanks for watching.
Cool, thanks guys. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and click the bell to stay notified of future updates.
See you next week.